We've made it to the last stop of the Speaking of Chemistry California road trip. But to quote one of the world's greatest scientists,
"Where we're going, we don't need roads."
Let's dive into some atmospheric chemistry with Kimberly Prather of UC San Diego and the Scripps Institution of Oceanography to learn more about the mysterious connection between the sea and the sky, including how bacteria help make it rain, literally.
Very little is known about what actually escapes from the ocean right now.
Well, that's a short episode. JK, you guys, JK. Researchers don't completely understand the chemistry of what the ocean dispatches into the atmosphere, but they do know there are lots of compelling reasons to study it. Kim, for instance, looks at the composition of aerosol particles in the atmosphere and the relationship of that chemistry to weather and climate. When people think of aerosol particles in the sky, they usually think of soot, the small carbon-rich chunks that come from burning fuels like wood and gasoline. Soot shows how dark particles in the atmosphere can absorb radiation from the sun and warm up the planet. But there are also natural aerosols, dust from deserts, particles formed with the help of fragrant terpene compounds from forests, and if you'll permit me to be glib, crud from the ocean. These natural particles can contribute to global heating and cooling too, and they play an important role in precipitation as well. More on that in a minute. When it comes to sources of natural aerosols, though, Kim's really interested in the ocean because it makes up more than 70% of the Earth, and so much of its chemistry is still a mystery. To try and change that, she founded a research facility called CASE, or the Center for Aerosol Impacts on Climate and the Environment, if you're not into the whole brevity thing. CASE is this huge lab that literally brings the ocean inside. This lets Kim and her colleagues study the sea in a more controlled fashion than is possible in the wild blue yonder. So here's what we know so far. The ocean sprays salt into the sky, not a big surprise. But most of what the sea sends up is actually organic material, things like proteins, lipids, and even bacteria, and it's everywhere.
There's a really thin layer, it's almost like a thin skin that coats the entire surface of the ocean. It's less than a millimeter thick. That's a hydrophobic, lots of hydrophobic organic material.
The ocean can easily kick this stuff out into the air through waves crashing and air bubbles bursting. When it comes to bacteria though, the ocean isn't throwing things out willy-nilly. The ocean appears to shoot certain bacteria out preferentially, and Kim's trying to figure out which bacteria go airborne using genetics.
Right now, we're looking at the selective transfer. We're trying to see what DNA and what RNA is in the seawater versus what gets launched. And so the question is why?
That's a tantalizing mystery, and it gets even sweeter when you know that certain bacteria, such as Pseudomonas syringae, can actually help make it rain. The ocean and other natural sources can actually launch bacteria high enough up into the atmosphere to join other aerosol particles that help ice crystallize and form clouds. You know, rainmakers.
At the center of every cloud drop, at the center of every ice crystal, is a particle. Only one in a million particles in the atmosphere will actually form an ice crystal. And there's something very, very magical about the chemistry of those particles that do. And that's like the big question that chemists right now are really, really working hard to try and answer.
The chemistry of natural aerosols could be particularly magical. Atmospheric chemists, including Kim, recently joined forces with meteorologists and found that storm clouds grow naturally with bacteria and desert dust appear to drop more precipitation than clouds seeded with other aerosols, such as those from air pollution. Understanding the chemistry of natural aerosols could therefore help us humans learn to grow better rain clouds, which is actually something we've been working on since the 1940s. Sean Connery, you may remember, even dabbled in the 1998 documentary, The Avengers. But even without this sci-fi-esque application, it's still pretty rad we're finding new connections between the natural systems on our planet.
I think people are starting to realize there's much more of a coupling between the meteorology and the atmospheric chemistry than people ever believed before, but that is a brand new area of research that we have a long ways to go.
Huge thanks to Kim and Jillian Kemsley, who actually conducted the interview you saw with Kim. Jillian's covered a lot of atmospheric chemistry for C&EN, and we've shared some of our favorite stories in the description below. And lastly, huge thanks to all of you out there watching. We had a blast on this road trip, and we hope you did too. Check out the entire trip in this playlist and hit us up in the comments with suggestions for who we should visit next.